Hello, good morning everyone. This is my first tutorial on YouTube where I'll be explaining this Altium Designer 17 and how you can create a PCB out of this software in a very rapid manner. Well, this is the Altium Designer we have, and the topics we'll be covering in this session will be some general settings before we proceed to the project. We have to do this. Create a project, schematic generation, PCB generation, shortcuts, output generation, and a special case study. So this is the Altium screen we have. In any case, we do not find any of the tabs. We can directly go in view, desktop layout, we give a default, we get the same screen where we go to this projects and we have the libraries in the right hand side. First of all, we'll make a new project, PCB project. I give it a name, test. Default. Okay, so we have a test project created, and under this we'll add two files. One is a schematic and the other is a PCB. Well, we will save this. Control S. This is a test schematic I created, and I'll save this also with test PCB. Okay, so we'll be drawing this simple circuit in Altium. Go to the libraries and pin it so that it doesn't auto hide. So this is having a library bar, and Altium provides two libraries. One is for devices, one is for connectors. When you see the devices, they have a footprint given over here, and then down we can see. Okay, so we have to ensure some of the settings in order to start. Some general settings, like I said, if anything is gone, we go to the view, desktop layout, and default if there is any problem. Okay, so we'll set some of the settings for the schematic as well as for the PCB. We'll go to tools, and we got schematic preferences where we can set some of the parameters, but here we have nothing to do. And in the test PCB also, you can have some of the settings like tools. You go to preferences. Here we have to take care, like we have a general in the PCB editor general, and we take it cursor type large. I'll tell you why I took it large. By default it is in small or small 90 or 45. So first of all, let's take it and we give it OK, and there's a test page. Draw this. We have the resistance. We can go into devices, type a star before typing anything. It will find out the proper match. We get a resistance, schematic symbol, and the footprint. We get a resistance. Okay, we have an LED, taking this generic LED. Then we have a transistor, that is an NPN transistor. One resistance. This battery will not be using, will be giving a connector in place of this battery. And this capacitor, that is a polarized capacitor we have, so we can go with this capacitor too. That was pretty big, so I went with this capacitor CAP2. Fine, we have bought all the items. Okay, so we have the resistance. If we need to rotate any item, we will just select that item and press space bar, and it keeps on rotating. Okay, another thing we can do is before placing an item, suppose I have dropped an item, I did not place it still now. Before placing, I can press the space and we can place it the way we want. I'm deleting this. Well, this transistor is in this direction. We need a resistance. I copied and paste. I'll paste it. Before pasting it, I will rotate it and I will paste this in this direction. I have to draw a vase right now, and I have shortcut by pressing PWO or this vase. Both are the same. I press PWO. I'm keeping this two terminations. As I said, I'll be taking that from the library. I go into this connector and take a header, two pin header, and I need in this direction. You can rearrange if these are connected together. Now I need to add this VCC and the ground. So the VCC is in the ground position, down position as per the circuit, and the top. Okay, so we have the circuit ready. the numberings are not proper, right? So we need to rename them as per the schematic, or if it is a different circuit, we are handling a big circuit, we can annotate them automatically. For this, we'll go to Tools, Annotation, Annotate Schematics Quietly. What the software does is it automatically places the numbering and take care of any duplication errors. Okay. In the beginning, I told you about some of the general settings that I did. Like for the size of this page, I have changed it to letter. You can see it by going to Design and Document option. Sheet option, you can even change the parameters based on your criteria. I have taken it this as A4 page, and similarly for this also you can document option in design and board options, and in design and board options if we look, you can see that I'm working in mills. Okay, you can even change it to metric also, but what we're looking on is a page setup for this PCB, and same here I can set it to A4, give it close. Okay. So when I'm done the schematic, I need to import these items over there. We'll go to Tools, Design, Import Changes from Test. Here we give check everything, validate and execute the changes. And once we're given, we can see in the bottom, everything is being called from the schematics. This will keep on coming on the number of the schematic pages. Means if you're having one schematic or two, three schematics of schematic, and that is being imported, it will keep on creating number of schematics. So we'll delete this and we'll select all. Okay, and we can place them in the board. But before we do this, we'll set some of the rules for the board, and I'll show you in what way we can arrange these items. Well, one is manually we can drag and drop everything from outside and bring inside this big area. Before you go there, we have to select this Tools, Component Placement, Arrange within a rectangle. So we can define a rectangle over here, and everything from there is being called over there. That works with big circuits. The method is like auto placement. So that doesn't auto places your component, but that auto places in a defined area that you can give. The board is pretty big, and we need to predefine the board. Before going there, we need to set the origin. Let's see where the origin is. We can see by pressing Control and End. So here we see that the origin is here. We will go to Edit Origin, set the origin, place it here. So this is just a reference point. For our convenience, you can place it bottom left corner, or you can place it anywhere. But before the actual placement, we'll define the board by having some of the rules set that we'll find in rules. Go to rules, we'll have the width of this routing. I'll give it 20, this will be 18. 17. This is as per your requirement. You can give that width, and we need to take care of this routing layers. You have to see that the bottom layer is unchecked and the top layer is checked, and you give apply. Okay, and we'll go to view board planning mode. We'll change the board size so that we can fit all the components in our desired area. We'll go to design, redefine the board shape by going to this area. Suppose I define this area for my board. There are some options by pressing the shift key and the space key, which gives you a round neck over here and some angular curve, but I needed a square, so I'm going in this manner. Right click before coming to the origin. Okay, in any case, you find this origin, need to change this origin. You can even go to edit origin and set it. You can place it in the middle itself. That makes no issues at all. Now we come back to the layout mode. We'll place the components. We'll do it manually since there are a very little components, and there is a auto placement, but that doesn't work fine always. Only the component auto placement that I have shown you in the Tools, Component Placement, and you go with this arrange within the rectangle, that is pretty good for big circuits. I'll be placing this LED here, and in some case in a manual method, like I can place this drawing a tracks and draw it manually from one point to another, or we have other options. See, these are having 90 degrees, so these are not permitted in PCB design. We have to press shift and space so that it gets a curve or it gets to an angle. So now this is the mode where I actually want it, by pressing space, shift and space together. And I can go with this design in manual routing. But well, I will not waste my time doing this, since I have an option of routing auto route all. Before going there, we set the rules. We've seen that before. I'll route all, and this is done. The routing is done. Wow, the area where you need you think that you need to delete this tracks, you can draw that manually even after auto route is done. You can go there and do your manual routing. So this is the auto route we have got. Now another thing I need to show is, suppose I need to have some holes in the board where we use for placing. We can use some pads and place it over here directly, or we can go to design and board shape. We define a board cut, so where I can define a board cut over here. Sometimes it's very essential. Well, an enclosure design and all, we get that. This board cut, when you see in this 3D mode, you see that the board is cut. Okay. Now we have to do a holes placement like. So what I generally do is, in miscellaneous tab, we have an antenna. Devices, you get antenna. We generally, we can give them a common ground. Give them a ground over here. So what we need to do is, we need to annotate them, since we have duplications. So this is done. We'll save this test page and tools and design will import from test. So it will show some errors, but we know that these errors are not these errors, because with the items that we have already executed, only the items we have got these items and deleted the screwing holes or the mounting holes, you say. If we see in this board planning mode, or this 3D look, then you can understand this looks pretty good. But what is the reason behind taking this antenna and connecting to ground? I'll show you. Better noise humidity. We take the ground, give OK. Now I'm drawing the polygon pore. Before I pour the polygon, I'll just do one thing. I'll just unroot it all. Since a new net is created, I'll go to root, auto root all. Okay, we got this everything rooted. Fine. Now we can place the polygon pore. Okay, so I can start from here. And then itself, I can go every edge to edge. Here you need not bother about, because this is a cut. Okay, so we have got the polygon pore. Let's say in 3D mode is done. So here we have successfully created this PCB. We have covered the routing, 3D holes, antenna, some of the shortcut like. Yes, one thing I need to add is the grid on and off. So here you have the grid option, so we can toggle that. Control shift and G, so it makes the screen pretty clear. You can see that I place it on, off, on, off. So it's pretty good while you work. And here, if you are trying to do the same, it will ask a snap grid. By default, this is being 5 mm. So when you are zooming, you can see that there are a lot of rectangle, that there is a grid size. You can change it from here. I'm continuing with the output files creation, like the fabrication input outputs we have. We have the fabrication output. We can see the curve files from here. We take the files you need, the layers. Each layer will be a single file you need. You can select all the files you need. You can select and go with OK. I'm not doing this because I don't need at this point of time. Well, another thing, like you want to print a preview or have a smart PDF to see how your file looks like, then you can have this option of both the schematic and you just go with next, next, next and finish. And by default, some so it creates a schematic where everything is detailed. Or if you can click on this parameters and you can see the LED library description and everything over here. Okay, and this is the PCB. It will show you in a different layout we have selected. Now there's the test output, we can save it. Well, I don't need this at this point of time. Now the main thing I want to share is, like, we have special case study for schematic creation with the components and the PCB footprints we don't have in the library. So in that case, what do we need to do? Well, in that case, you similarly we have to add a new schematic library where we'll be adding the schematic. Same, we go to the projects, we add another PCB library. Hope you understand the concept. We'll have the schematic library that consists of the schematic and the PCB library. The schematic is this and the footprint is this, means the PCB library we say. So in the schematic library we can add components. So you select this, go to this SCH library. By default the component is given. So if I am to make an IC, so generally that is given denoted by U, and that is you have to add a question mark that will be used in the annotations you learned earlier. So you have this component on. I gave this IC dip 4. I'll be creating an IC of a dip 4 standard. They give that okay. So this is a component. In the same way you can add another component, like we can add dip. I'll give IC dip 8, creating two ICs. One is dip 4 and dip 8. So I double click on that. That is showing default designator U. And similarly on this, is I have to mention this as U question mark. Okay, so I select this and I'll add, like you will be adding pins to this diagram, this rectangle. I'll place pins, spacebar. I can place this, I can rotate this. I'll press tab for more information I need. Display is one, designator is one. Okay, I can give it passive, no issues. Or if it is a power pin, suppose I'm giving it is a power pin, okay, one. Okay, suppose I'm creating an IC with power pin one, I can give it 2, 3, and 4. So if say this is the power, by default this is taking the same settings, so I need to manually change them. This is suppose this is the power, as I said earlier, 4. I'm also giving power, okay, fine. And 2 I'll be giving as input, okay. And this would be an output. So these two are the power pins to the IC, okay, fine. Now I go to this, the 4 is doing this dip 8, similar manner. What I can do is I can even, I've not tried this option before, but I'm trying it. I can copy this, I can open this, I can paste it. Paste. I can paste this. Okay, fine, that works pretty well. Okay, I did not rotate that in previous IC. I can rotate this. Okay, what I did is I copied the same IC and I enlarge it more in this manner. Okay, I have got two power pins. I'll place more pins. Pin. So before I place this, I'll go into tab. I'll give it input. So I have 8 pin IC. So for example, I say this pin is power and this pin is also power. Okay. So I can define this as input, make it output. So one input, one output. It depends on the IC that you were creating. Okay, so this is a manual method that we did. Right, this is only the schematic. This is only a schematic. Okay, so this is schematic library also needs to be saved. We can press Ctrl S and then this gives the schematic library, schematic one library. I give it save. Okay, it's saved. Similarly, we have the PCB library. We double click on here, go to the PCB library. Same, we have the component over here. We double click it. Suppose I'm giving it dip for like before. Okay, and this is the origin that you can see. Same control, and here you can even in similar way we did earlier. You have this origin set by default in here. In any case, you go somewhere, you give control and end, that will bring you to this place. Okay, this is the first pin we have got. So I can play that manually by counting the holes and going over there to the place where I need, means a 100 distance from this point to another pad, 100 distance. Like if I say I want to measure, I'll give control M. So this is the measurement bar, means from starting from here I have to go to a certain lot of calculations need to be done. So this is the measurement tool, so it is showing like that. I'll give shift C to clear that. Well, I have to place a pin with 100 mils pitch because I'm creating a dip4 IC. I'll give it control X for cut. I'll select the origin to make it, it is copied in the background. I'll edit and give it paste special. Paste on current layer, paste array. I give it a spacing of 100 mils in X, means from in this position it will be 100. The item count would be 2 because I'm creating only 2 pins. Okay, I go to the origin and click it. Okay, so if you measure it right now, see, we have exactly got 100 mils. We need not calculate anything because from this origin to this origin is 100 mils, and this is the software already gave. Okay, now I need to place 2 more pins above it with the distance of say 200 mils from this point. So I don't know how, what is the is that the origin or something. If I keep on moving my cursor, so here it changes. So at any point I need to make down to 0, I press it, insert, and it goes 0. See, it goes to 0. This left hand side is always moving, but this right hand side point is, you can change it. So what I will do is I'll select this. So here it shows 0. Well, I need to paste this pins again. 200 mils on up. I can give it minus because I'll be moving from this right to left 0. But where exactly I need? I said that I'll be placing this in 200. So you can see this is a origin. If you make it like this origin, right? So I go to 200, 150, 200 mils is up to here. I give it a click. 3-4 is, wow, that's really great. Okay, I can add another component, new blank component. I can give dip4. I'll be creating dip8 for this component. In the similar way, what I can do is I'll place one pad. Before placing, I'll give it 1. Okay, select and cut it and come to the origin and click once. It's gone. Edit, paste special, paste array, because then I'm working in an array with similar distance of, I'll be getting 8 pin IC will be having 4 legs in one side. I'll go to this. Wow, that's great. It is placing 4 pins, and I need more 4 pins starting from this position to there, to the left hand side, and I need a distance of 200 mils. What I will do is I will again give paste special, paste array. I'll give this negative and same this count. So again it comes. So here I need to make it 0. I'll give it 0. I'll go there till 200. 205, go zoom it, 195, this is the 200, I click here. Wow, Got this. You can boundary it, like I go to top overlay, I give a line. Okay, I give a line over here. I draw an IC. Okay, we save it. Similarly for the dip also we can do that. That I missed in that beginning. Wow, we got two ICs created. Now we need to map this footprint to the schematic library so that we can add that in the schematics we are drawing. Means we'll be placing a component here. So we need to add footprint to that. Add footprint, we'll browse and we'll see that it is having this already called because this is a library we created. Okay, we'll select the four, assign it. Okay, same for dip 8, add footprint, browse dip 8. Okay, fine. So now we can add this from the schematics. See, there is option of component footprints in 3D models. Okay, so these are the lot of libraries that I called in the beginning. So, and by default these are called because we made it few minutes back. What I will do is I will go to this library that I created. This is schematic library one, and I drag and drop. We get that. Wow, that's easy. And similar way for this 8 pin, we can even rotate this as by pressing the space. Well, we learned about the library creation and a manual method, and even we can create some components and the automated method where Altium provides this feature, component creation. We also have a automated component creation for some of the generic devices. Go to this component wizard by right clicking in. And click on next. Say for example, I'm in need of creating a dip IC that I created a few minutes back. There is the diameter of the hole. You have 30 mils, it's 50 mils. 600 mils is the pitch that is given, and 100 mils is the distance that we created was 200, so I'm creating the same. Okay, so the distance of the, I am so sorry, and this is 100 mils that you created and the distance was 200 mils. I can give a next and the value of the outline that you need. I can give it next and I can give the number of pins as 4. Since it is a 4, so 2 here and 2 here it shows. I can give it a 4 next and give it finish. So here we have this IC with the 4. I can save it. I can add a component wizard. So that's pretty fast when we have some of the generic components, like we want 25 mils or 31 mils. That really matters. I think the distance is 100 is given. I need of 200. Okay, and that is 8 pin dip. Finish. Wow. So every pairs are given an extra area for solder mounting where we created. That would take a pretty larger time in creating in that way, because this is a dip 8 footprint, and in dip 4 I need to add footprint of dip 4. So this is the dip 4 and this is the duplicate mesh which we created. That's pretty great. And in that, in the similar way, we can add the various different components like capacitor, edge connectors, leadlet chip caps, SOP packages, and many more. Thank you guys for watching my video. Hope you have liked, and it will be very easy for creation of schematic PCB. You have learned about this PCB library also. Yeah, another thing I show, like the split screen and two screens. Well, I'll close this one and I will close this too. when we were working with this placement, so sometimes if you're working with a big circuit, you might be confused that which component is actually which. So you will be in a complex situation of toggling the windows. So here is a very good option of right clicking over here, and you can go with split vertical and split horizontal. You can split horizontal. You select something. By default, that gets selected.